Welcome to Omaha, Nebraska, game two of the NCAA College World Series. And it's the Florida Gators in a must-win situation against the Gamecocks of South Carolina.
The concourse is great here, all the amenities. This ball driven down the left field line. Peter Mooney on his way to second. He was the most outstanding player in the 2010 College World Series. Breaking pitch in the air to right. It's going to be caught by Tucker. His throw to the plate not in time, and Ringo comes through. A sacrifice fly and an RBI first run of the game.
Sometimes you just don't feel as confident with that grip when you're swinging.
Chopped to short and off the shortstop's glove in the center field. That's going to get a run home. Nolan Fontana can't come up with a tough bounce. The ball goes into center field. It's 2-0. Two on, two out, 3-2 to the hitter. Chopped up the middle over the mound. Going to be a tough play. Safe for the run score. Adams did everything he could coming in from second base. It was just hit in exactly the right place. You watch South Carolina play two or three ball games. You just have to be terribly impressed by these kids. That ball is blasted to deep right field, and it's gone. Mooney got out in front of it and hits his fourth home run of the year. And for South Carolina, their first home run in five games at the College World Series. Times this year he has come out of the bullpen. That's second all time. And Roth will get a huge ovation from the Gamecock faithful.
Bounced up.
Ringo. Wouldn't you know? Scott Ringo comes through for another big base hit. He comes back and pitches an inning 2 days later for a save. Now this ball is into left center field. Jackie Bradley makes the catch. South Carolina has done it. Back to back national titles. Tanner and his kids. They have rewritten the record books here at the College World Series. Nobody had ever won 16 games in a row in the NCAA tournament